Ah, the Taj Mahal.
Yeah, it's almost ethereal.
That is shit. You want some?
No, I'm alright.
No, I was talking to Dean. Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Hello.
My name's Paul. This is Bethany.
Hello.
Yeah, and this is Dean, the horse. We just moved in upstairs.
Cool.
So we're just like introducing ourselves to people.
Cool.
And saying hello, you know.
Nice one. Whereabouts are you?
We're just upstairs there, and the one there, we just moved in above you, I think.
Oh, okay. Number 3, is
yeah.
It? Okay, cool.
Yeah, so, but just, we have to let you know on, sort of council-wise, that we've been moved here on an anti-social behaviour order. Do you know what that is?
Oh, okay.
We've been moved from Leon Solent because there was some trouble where we lived. A lot of the people didn't like the animals and Dean living in the flat, you know, so...
The yeah. Horse.
Well, Dean's going to have to live there for like 6 months and then hopefully, if Bethany gets a job,
yeah.
Then we'll be able to find stabling for him. Otherwise, we'll send him off to one of those French butchers that make, like, hamburgers of him, you know. But he's a nice horse, you know, he won't cause any problems
yeah.
unless... Unless he gets angry, he doesn't like sugar. Never give him sugar if you
okay.
see him, because
right.
he'll go nuts, you know.
Okay.
So
does he go get angry often? Or?
He gets angry only if he gets given sugar or if he's like in a bad mood. So he's all right. About 3 o'clock, he likes a gallop. So if he goes along the front and stuff, you know what's happening. It's just a horse.
Cool. Okay.
Yeah. All right. Nice to meet you.
Nice one.
Yeah. Cheers.
Okay, yeah.
You haven't got a fag for the horse, have you?
I'm afraid not, me.
All right. All right. Cheers. All right. We'll come down for a drink tonight, maybe. Yeah.
Cool.
Lovely. All right. Nice area, isn't it?
Lovely.
Well, like this. Yeah. It's nice. Bet you're wondering what I got under my kilt. Aye? It's a chicken that I'll be cooking tonight. I'll be off now.
Where would you suggest would be the best takeoff place here, like the shortest width
bit? I can't even suggest any of that.
Right.
Because...
But is it all like wide across or is there a shorter bit? Because in tests I'm doing like 1.5 miles, so I need to just be able to cross that.
You know what, I wouldn't even recommend anything, because if something happens to you, then we're going to be liable.
But I've got a helmet, so...
That helmet ain't gonna help you in the canyon years. I mean.
Okay, I don't know if you're familiar with Cheddar Gorge in England,
yeah.
But I've jumped that 3 times with this baby, and that's like 400 meters wide. I'm gonna go test the wind. Fuel check, I need a wind gauge, and I need a lighter. Come on guys, I got a canyon to cross.
Gotta get a second chance to the jigs just started. Gotta give it up. Give it up.
We go? Clear! What the hell are you doing? You're making me look like a monkey. Okay guys, we've got technical difficulties with the wind, so we might be like half an hour if you just be patient. We'll have a go at 4 o'clock. This is embarrassing, professionally embarrassing. This wouldn't happen at Cheddar Gorge, buddy. It's a bloody joke, Tim. It's a bloody joke. Hello.
Hi.
Information?
Yes.
Yes. David and John came down to breakfast in the hotel this morning, and there was a basket of bread rolls. There were 40 bread rolls, and they were €2.50 each. Now, David had 6 rolls, and John, who was hungrier, had 12 rolls. If David paid for all the rolls they ate, and they had a kitty of €50 for the day, how much change would they have to spend in the day?
Ik vroeg me zus ook af.
No conferring, and you need to show you're working on paper, please.
Pardon, working on paper?
Any working out of the answer you need to show on a paper, and there's no conferring, you've got 2 minutes.
Is this a game? Or I don't quite understand. Do I have to calculate or something?
I'm just setting the questions. I can't help you with this, I'm afraid.
Just with the question, yes, but I don't know. I'm not calculating. I only give tourist information. So.
Okay. Well, I'm afraid I'm going to have to fail you. But what I'll do is I'll come back in a week and we'll see how well you do then. Okay.
Everything I thought meant something seems so unappealing. I'm ready for the real thing, but nobody's selling, no. Except you and yours, saying open up your eyes and ears and let me in. Let's go out of your brilliant minds. You must be out of your brilliant minds.
Hello, mister.
Hello.
Have you got any odd jobs that we might be able to do? We're looking to make some sort of spare money. Nothing?
I do it myself.
You what?
I do it myself.
Oh, okay. Well, we're not allowed to work in the garden or outside.
Yes.
Because we've got allergies and hay fever, so we can't. And inside the house, we're not allowed to go because of stranger danger. So, but if you've got anything that's not in the garden or in the house, we can do that. As long as it's before 5 o'clock.
I've got all the help I need.
Okay. Oh. Well, we can't do it after 5 o'clock because we go binge drinking. So, but before 5 o'clock, that's all right. All right? If you let everyone in the area know that we're available, and that would be good, yeah? We're £20 an hour each. Can't work before 5 o'clock. Obviously with the allergies, can't be in the garden, and not allowed in the house because of stranger danger. But apart from that, we'd do anything.
Okay.
All right?
Bye-bye now.
Thank you. Bye. Nice man, isn't he? Lovely man. Skinnies! Skinnies!
Who's been eating grapes then?
Yeah, you're on Atkins, are you? Skinny! Put some weight on you, skinnies!
You're lying! Oh, it's ridiculous!
You fit bastards!
You're well proportioned, you are!
Yeah! Oh, do weights! And look, run! Go on, run, skinny!
Ah! Paris.
It is a magnificent city, eh? Incroyable. You are French? You are from here, or?
No, from New Zealand.
Ah, you're from New Zealand?
Mm-hmm.
home of the kangaroo.
No, that's Australia.
Ah, okay. Sorry. You have ever had a Frenchman?
Yeah.
We are remarkable men in many ways, you know. A lot of us are painters. I personally am a painter, a novelist, unpublished, but I write, you know.
You paint landscapes?
Huh?
Landscapes and portraits?
I paint nudes, mostly. Nude women, I love women, you know, so. French women, very much. It is an honor for them to pose naked, you know, in my loft. So, it is the French way, you know. It's my birthday.
So what?
I'm 77 years old.
Yeah, so what? You don't mean you've got a blown air horn in my ear, does it?
It's my birthday. I'm just celebrating it.
Yeah, good for you. Happy birthday.
Thank you very much. Guess how old I am?
Yeah, you just said you're 77.
I'm 77 years old. It's good, isn't it?
Yeah, it's great.
Happy birthday to me.
Yeah. Good for you.
I'm having a party.
Good for you.
Goodbye. Guess how old I am?
Yeah, you said already.
Guess.
Yeah, you said 77.
77, yes.
Not anymore, they don't.
Everything okay?
Yes, thank you.
Yeah. I've just moved into the area.
Really?
So if there's any problems, just give us a shout.
Yeah, so what do we call you?
Sorry?
What do we call you?
I am Metal Joe.
Metal Joe.
Yeah, I've just been released from a metal institution.
Yeah.
And basically I use my metal powers to combat anything. So if you come up against anything you can't deal with, just give us a shout. Yeah?
Yeah.
Good. One day a real rain will come.
Yes.
Wash the scum off the streets. But until then...
No, we have to fight here.
And we shall do this together. Nice talking to you.
Thank you.
How often, seriously, do like New Zealand men... How often do they wash? Because for me, seriously, I wash like once every 2 weeks is fine. But I hear like in England they wash every day. It's like, this is such a waste of like valuable time, you know? You know, a time I could be spent, you know, loving and painting and writing. I am not gonna sit there scrubbing, you know, what is this? This is ridiculous. You think it is wrong, 2 weeks? No?
C'est la vie.
C'est la vie, yes. Yes. It's a very relaxed attitude you have to personal hygiene. It's great, I like that.
Oh,
Everybody was kung fu fighting. Those kids were fast as lightning. In fact, it was a little bit frightening. But they fought with expert timing. There were funky China men from funky Chinatown. They were chopping back.
Excuse me, mate. Are you going in the news agent?
Oh, yeah.
Would you get us a girly magazine, please, if we give you £5?
Go on.
Oh, go on, please.
Thanks, mate.
Just give us £5. Get us a girly magazine off the top shelf. Please, quick. He won't sell it to us.
Please.
Just, here, just take it. You can keep the change. Just get one with big baps, yeah?
Oh,
something with big baps. Oh, brilliant. Which one? Oh, brilliant. Cheers, mate.
Right.
Thanks very much for that.
Right.
Thanks a lot. Oh, let's go. We got one. It's got bats.
I know a girl with a golden touch. She's got enough, she's got too much. You could have it all if you wanted. You could have it all if it mattered so much. But then all is how to put you down when you're there, they're your friend. But then when you're not around, they say, oh, she has changed. You know what they mean? Well, they mean they're just jealous because they never do the things they wish that they could do so well.
Sorry to disturb you, but we're doing a police lineup in the town hall. Are you aware of a police lineup? Where basically we have four suspects lined up against a wall, and someone who's made a complaint has to identify someone. And basically we're supposed to legally by law have five people against the wall, and one of them hasn't shown up. And we're just wondering if we could borrow you for 1 minute just to fill the numbers. All you have to do is stand against the wall and do it. Is that all right?
What happens if they pick me?
To be honest, we've got a fairly good idea of who the chap is.
Right, if you could just stand in against the wall, please. Okay, can you all hold up your numbers, please? Right, this is a formal police identification parade, so I would ask you to look straight forward, make no communication with the people next to you.
Number three, could you step out, please, and say, I'm going to eat your face. I'm going to eat your face, loudly, please.
I'm going to eat your face. I'm going to eat your face.
Slightly louder, please, number three.
I'm going to eat your face. I'm going to eat your face.
Thank you. And number four?
I'm going to eat your face. I'm going to eat your face.
Thank you. I'm going to ask number three and number four to do one more, please. Could we ask you to step forward and say, I can have you killed for £3,000. Number three, please. Loudly, please.
I can have you killed for £3,000.
Thank you. Step back. Number four.
I can have you killed for £3,000.
Thank you, number four. Okay, we're going to have to make a definite decision.
Hello. I'm an undercover TV reporter. I'm a master of disguise, and using secret cameras like this one on my head and secret microphones on my shirt, I catch bad guys on television. This week, I'm going to catch the people that sell cigarettes to little kids.
It's me, in disguise. Surely they wouldn't sell cigarettes to a baby.
Can I get 20 B&H, please?
Conclusive proof. I've just bought a packet of cigarettes in that shop, and yet I am clearly under 3 years old. What the hell is going on? I'm British Bob.
British Bob?
Yeah. I came here and thought I'd try and, jump the canyon, but...
It didn't work.
It was a bit bigger than I thought, yeah. So I started up there, had a big crowd. Now, problems with lighting the fuse, and then finally it went. And it just went pear-shaped. The first arc was good, and then I just smashed straight down in there by the river.
Yeah, all right.
Well, I had a helmet, luckily, so...
Yeah.
You know, I mean, you'd be crazy to try and jump across the Grand Canyon with a big rocket without a helmet. You know, I'm not an idiot.
Legs
all right. I'm just a bit shaken, to be honest, you know.
Put that down for a while.
I've got to get back up, have another go before it's dark, so, you know. You don't think I should have another go?
I don't think so.
No.
I don't think so.
Well, I've come all the way. It seems silly just to give up.
It's a lesson.
Yeah, but I'm not a quitter, you know.
No,
I'm not a quitter.
You think stop?
Stop.
Yes.
Stop.
Stop now?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, don't be
doing
it. It's just been a dream to jump across the Grand Canyon in a big rocket.
Have a
stop, you think? Yeah. Cup of tea, maybe?
Yeah, definitely.
Cup of tea would be good, wouldn't it? Yeah.
Yes. A lot of sugar.
A cup of tea, some sugar, and then I'll have another go. Yeah. So.
No. A cup of tea and sugar, and then forget it.
Forget it.
I'd forget it.
All right.
I think this has been, a lesson to
it. It's been quite a day, actually.
Yes.
Hello! Help! Help me, please! Oh, no! Please! Terrible things are happening here! Help! I'm trapped! Press the button, anything! Please let me out! I must run free!
Every day is so wonderful, and suddenly it's hard to breathe. Now and then I get insecure from all the pain. I'm so
would you be interested maybe in joining me ce soir for like a glass of wine in Paris?
I have to meet a friend.
Oh, really? Mm. Okay. You're not interested in a moonlit walk down the Seine?
No.
I could paint you nude in my loft, I write poetry about you.
No.
No? Cook with excessive amounts of garlic, you know, give you the whole French experience. No? That is good. That is a maybe, I think. I will be very honest with you, I am a fantastic lover. I am one of the best in Paris. Very, very caring lover, you know. I am big like a horse.
So deep, deep without a meaning. I knew you'd find me leaving. Tell us friends with cameras for eyes. The hands don't make me hang. They only make me feel like breathing. In unguarded moments. In unguarded moments. In unguarded moments. In unguarded moments. Unguarded moments.
in an unguarded moment.
Excuse me. You know that you're not allowed to skate here? Yeah? Yeah. You're not allowed to use these here?
Yeah, we're just walking.
What?
We're just walking.
I didn't fight a war so that someone like you could, like, ride these around and knock me over, you know that?
We were some rides in it, mate. We weren't knocking over.
You are. I walk along here and you come down here really fast and knock me over. I didn't storm the beaches of Normandy so that people like you could ride bits of wood. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Yes?
It wasn't our specialty.
I'm 77
like
years old.
I know you.
I can't do that, can I?
No, you can't.
But you're doing it and I don't understand.
It wasn't us personally that ran you over though.
No, but you're all the same.
We're not all the same.
All listening to hippity hop and stuff. You are.
Right, we're all the same.
You are. I stormed Normandy. I've killed Germans. Not so that you can do this.
Okay.
You should get jobs.
Got
why don't you have jobs?
Yeah.
Well, go and work.
We're not at work.
Go on. Go, don't you hanging around like a gang.
We are a gang.
What are you?
We're a gang.
What are you, Crips?
Crips?
Come on, go.
Oh, where? Stand in.
What do you mean, where? I didn't ask where when I got to Normandy. I just killed Germans. Go. You make me sick. Go! It's my birthday! Skinny! Skinny! Think it's clever to be fitted, do you? Skinny! Come on, people! People!
You can keep your Brussels and Amsterdam. Give me back my summer and Dresden, man. But they still got peace police over there. Drawing lines on a map just to show I'm there. GG.
Have some pies!
Low-fat yogurt, eater!
Eat some chips! You know it makes sense, skinny!
For a small bum!
Fit bastard!
You're too poor!